History has recorded numerous brutal experiments on human bodies. In the name of scientific purposes, there are experiments in the history of science that, when we look back, we cannot help but feel outrage and shame. These experiments, conducted by those considered masters in their fields, have crossed the boundaries of ethics and human rights, leaving indelible scars in the minds of the victims. These experiments are a testament to the brutality that humans can inflict on each other in the pursuit of knowledge. Human castration to assess endurance. Approximately 400 terrifying experiments truly created a horrific nightmare for thousands of victims. The father of these experimental programs was Reichsfuhrer Himmler, the man responsible for the deaths of about 6 million Jews in the Holocaust massacre. He was the commanding officer of the Schutzstaffel, the most brutal armed organization of Nazi Germany, and their main victims were prisoners of all ages. No one was excluded. The elderly, children, women, men, even if they were in good health, were forced to endure being injected with typhus into their bodies with increasing doses. Then, they had to endure being left out in cold weather until they froze to death. Many men were brutally castrated or shot with toxic bullets. The purpose of these perverse experiments was only to assess the endurance of the human body. Live dissections. The idea for these horrifying experiments originated from Unit 731. A covert force specializing in biological and chemical warfare research, also infamous for the war crimes committed by fascist Japan, to study the functioning of internal organs in the human body. Unit 731 conducted live dissections without anesthesia. Thousands of men, women, and children, mostly prisoners of communist China, as well as elderly farmers, they were infected with diseases such as typhus and plague under the guise of vaccination. After infection, Unit 731 performed autopsies to examine how these diseases affected the body before and after the victims died. They also studied the decomposition process of organs in the body. In addition, the Maruta, a term used by Unit 731 to refer to those experimented upon, had their limbs amputated and reattached to different parts of their bodies. Some were beaten to a pulp, or had their digestive systems cut out to observe the process of necrosis. After the bodies of the Maruta had fulfilled their duty, they were shot or injected with poison until they died, and some were even buried alive. All prisoners from China, Mongolia, Korea, or Russia who were transferred to Unit 731 did not survive. The ones most directly affected by these experiments were the unfortunate prisoners. The scientists here performed direct surgeries on these prisoners without using anesthesia, just to study diseases. They dissected the midsection of the prisoners, then inoculated them with bacteria, causing rickettsia fever and typhus. Those lucky enough to survive would then be hanged until death. Sterilization experiments. After coming to power in Germany, fascist leader Hitler ordered doctors to carry out horrific experiments. Among these were the inhumane sterilization experiments that Nazi Germany conducted at the Auschwitz and Ravensbrück concentration camps. Sterilization experiments were part of the Nazis' racial hygiene program, aimed at eliminating those they considered undesirable from the human gene pool. Those chosen to participate in these experiments were usually Jews, Romani, and others that the Nazis considered inferior races. These cruel and inhumane experiments were carried out under the approval of the Nazis' law for the prevention of hereditarily diseased offspring, enacted on July 14, 1933. The goal of this law was to prevent the inheritance of disadvantageous genes for future generations. about 300,000 people in concentration camps became the unfortunate victims of these experiments. They were asked to fill out a registration form, a way to deceive them. Sterilization methods included X-ray surgery, use of drugs or injection of iodine and silver nitrate into the body. These methods caused serious side effects, such as vaginal bleeding, severe abdominal pain, and cervical cancer. Later, doctors here prioritized using radiation sterilization methods. They made the room radioactive, thereby causing complete sterilization for the prisoners. Some people suffered severe radiation burns. The consequences of these experiments were horrific. Many people died or encountered serious health problems after participating in these experiments. Moreover, being sterilized took away their ability to reproduce, causing great psychological pain. These inhumane sterilization experiments are one of the clearest manifestations of the cruelty and inhumanity of the Nazi regime. They are a testament to the disregard for human rights. Experiments on twin pairs. Dr. Joseph Mengele, also known as the Angel of Death of the Auschwitz concentration camp operated by Nazi Germany, was responsible for this horrific experiment. His goal was to understand the similarities and differences in the genes of twin pairs. About 1,500 pairs of twins were drawn into these experiments. They were held in concentration camps throughout the experiment. The experimental methods that the doctors here used were extremely terrifying. They injected dye into the eyes of twin pairs to monitor whether the eyes changed color and performed blood transfusions between two siblings in a pair of twins to test blood compatibility. What's even more horrifying is that they sewed twin pairs together to create conjoined twins. In the end, only about 200 pairs of twins survived these experiments. For me, this experiment is truly horrifying. These experiments not only violated basic human rights, but also reflected the cruelty and indifference of those who conducted them. They exploited the trust and faith of others to carry out brutal experiments, sometimes harming or causing the death of innocent people. At the same time, it is a strong warning about what can happen when we allow scientific ambition to cross ethical boundaries. We need to remember that the ultimate goal of science is to serve the interests of humanity, not to harm each other. And stay tuned for part 2.